some nice relaxing music there to open us back up with great anticipation, David puts at the top of the chat. And yes, well, I'm here at the moment. Trevor hopefully will be joining us in a little bit, but we're just waiting for a delivery man to come and take a parcel away, setting a keyboard off to someone. And yes, and it's just Trevor and myself here in the shop today. But hello, everyone. Welcome to Alan's Music. It's a great pleasure to be back, just making sure I'm not sitting on any wires, to be back here at Alan's. I've been away for a couple of weeks myself on a trip to America on holiday. So it's great to be back. And today we are playing a wonderfully delicious pre-owned Wersi OAX500. This one's available right now. It's just come in as a part exchange. And gorgeous machine, and this one of course is in the white finish and has all the wonderful many of the wonderful features, I should say, of the Wersi Sonic range. So anyway, it's lovely to be back, and really missed playing for you all and having your company. So we'll just say a few hellos before we get started with any questions and answers you might you won't have any answers, but questions hopefully we can answer, as well as showing you around some of the great sounds of the Wersi Sonic. And this is that actually was a style we were using there, which was in the Latin bottom, and that was called Latin Impanema, which of course is very suggestive of a famous Latin American tune. But of course that would be but of course it goes with many other Latin tunes, as I showed you there with So Nice or the Summer Samba. David Hartong said there was no live stream last week, this caused a panic attack. Well, maybe now and anticipation is at its peak. Tom and Trevor are back. Yes, last week was everything happened at once last week. For those of you who maybe don't know, our managing director Con is unfortunately still off poorly at the moment with COVID, but he's on his on the mend slowly, which is good. And I'm sure you all send your best wishes to him, as many of you have phoned and done that already. So he says thank you so much for that, and looks forward to being back in the store very soon. I was trying to get back from America because I had two flights cancelled. The first one, the plane didn't work, so that was a good reason to cancel it. And then, of course, the second one got cancelled because of all the air traffic problems. So I got back very late on Tuesday afternoon. And, of course, Trevor was here and with Lucy, and Lucy's now away for a week on holiday. So it's just been myself and Trevor, and just me at the moment. But anyway, thank you, David, for your thing. Philip Russell says, good afternoon. Two questions. We'll come back to those. Philip, nice to hear from you. David Sanders, a very good and hot afternoon. It is going to be very warm this week, actually. It's kids have gone back to school nearly, so summer start. Barbara Kefford and Kevin, nice to see a Wersi this week. Yeah, absolutely. It's always good fun to play a Wersi. How are you both doing at the shop? We're doing all right, thanks, Barbara and Kevin. By the way, how is Con? Well, he's getting there slowly. He's getting there slowly, that's what we'll say. But as I say, we were passing on all the good wishes that everyone is sending for a swift recovery. Good afternoon from Steve in Edinburgh. Hello, Steve. Nice to see you, sir. Ernie in Cedar Falls. David in Penzance. Oh, jumped to the bottom of the queue there. Looking forward to seeing the dynamic duo and reunited. Well, hopefully if DPD come and collect a box, yes. Wayne Lux and Wes Stewart both say hello, as does Alan Gray from Bristol. Hello, Alan. Nice to hear from you. Wes Stewart says, I'm ready for the Tom and Jerry show. Oops, I mean the Tom and Trevor show. Yes. 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 Peter C, many happy returns to Con and Lucy and Tam. Yes, we've all had their birthdays not so long ago. On holiday. Actually, when I was in America, my son Joshua had his 10th birthday, which was like, geez, where did that go? Douglas Watts says hello, as does Graham Williams. And everyone's having a chat. Paul Denny, hello, Paul. Keith Darville, Alan Robinson, and Babs and Phil Wallace. So nice to hear from you both, absolutely. So everyone, Philip had a question at the top. And two questions. The MIDI sequencer, could you show us how this works, or maybe for a Patreon video, and also the style sequencer, and perhaps about how creating a style from scratch? Yes, to be honest, Philip, we would be here till about midnight if I went through both of those. So Trevor and I had a chat, and we said, yeah, that's two great topics, but it's going to probably need probably one or two videos maybe on each one, depending on how much we get into it. But basically, what Philip is asking, just to quickly summarise that, inside the Wersi Sonic, we have all these incredible features and functions. And in the settings menu, we have various options, but we actually do have a MIDI sequencer. Now, this obviously won't work at the moment because I haven't got a MIDI file loaded in. But that is where you go to do things with MIDI. And MIDI is a kind of a recording file that is used in digital instruments like keyboards and organs and pianos. And it allows you to make a recording in this and then play in another general MIDI compatible instrument, and then that instrument will perform the recording but using its own sound set. It's also a way of moving recordings from computers to instruments, so it's a very, very big topic. The style editor next door, what this does, this brings up a very intricate screen where you can actually go through and basically edit the style in question. So I'll just give you a very brief overview of this now. In fact, what I will do, as my cameraman isn't here, I shall have to get up and do my own camera work, but I think if I can do that, hang on, that's the microphone. Anyway, so the sequencer offers, the style editor offers this incredible range of tweakable things. So what we can do is we've got, there's the screen, that looks pretty good. So at the top of the screen here, we've got all the parts of the style, variation A, B, C, and all styles are made up of different parts. So we've got four variations. We've got A, B, C, D, three intros and three endings, four fill-ins, and two breaks as well. So there's multiple parts that make up a style. Beneath that are all the tracks of the style. It's a bit like multi-track recording with a style, in the sense that each style has multiple instruments playing multiple parts. So we've got the real drums, two drum tracks, a bass line, and five accompaniments. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, plus an extra one, which is the audio track down the bottom there. Now, why would you want to tweak a style? Well, there's multiple reasons. Something in it you might not like. Something in it you might like, but you want to change it. Something in it you might want to make louder, or something you might want to remove. So what we do is we start with our empanema style, and let's listen to variation D. Didn't see you there. So we have lots of things going on in there. Let's have a listen. Now, to start listening to those parts, we can use, in version 2.9 and higher, we can use the muting parts on the main screen to take out the accompaniments. So there's just the bass of the drums. So let's listen just to the drummer. Hand percussion, gongs, little tings. Here's the bass. That sounds kind of like an upright bass. Part one. Little electric piano going on there. Da, da, da. Classic rhythms there. Okay. Let's listen to part two. So this is section two. A little Latin piano. That's a pad, constant sound, strings. Not much going on in part four. And then we've got a little phrase, a little riff in part five. So not all the parts are always used. So with that style selected, I go to settings, and I go to page two. page one, and I press Style Editor. This then brings up this screen that most people then go, oh my goodness, oh, thank goodness for that. So you have to make sure that when you go in there, first thing is don't panic. And I said, we'll go through this in a lot of detail, but in a video on Patreon. But we can see here that if I've got Variation A selected at the top of the screen, I can then see all the instruments that are being used. Okay, so if I go to part D, I can then see at the top, look, it gives me the name. So I've got acoustic kit, Cuban kit, what's that one there? We've got an acoustic bass. So these little squares let me choose, that was actually a jazz guitar. It was a general MIDI jazz guitar, so it's a fairly basic sound. Grand piano, strings, nothing in part four, and then the flute. So let's say if I wanted to change the flute, I just tap that little square, look, and then I get my sound list come up. So what it then allows me to do is to change the flute for a different instrument. So why would we want to do that? Well, maybe we just don't like flutes. We want to ban them. Poor flutes. Let's go for something different, like a mallet sound. So I go to mallets, and I'm going to pick a marimba. So I load the marimba in. And so part five, accompaniment part five, now has had its instrument changed. Okay. Now, it only plays in the style editor, it only plays a small part of the style. Because the style lasts for two bars, okay, it says at the top there. I can put a play cycle on. And that keeps it going. Let's turn the volume up. Now, of course, the problem with the marimba is, of course, it dies away as soon as it's played. So I could change that maybe for an accordion. Okay, let's go for a mixed accordion. There we go. Now that has now changed the style. Now I haven't messed up the original because that is kept safe. Okay. So what I can then do is I can then say, okay, well, I want to change the pad sound, the strings, from strings organ one to strings orchestra. Now you have to remember that these sounds are not voices on the keyboard. These are the accompaniments voices. I could mess around with the drums, look. So turn the drums off and just have the hand percussion. Ooh, speed it up, obviously. And that's the thing, preset tempo can be changed. So there we go, got a nice just percussion there. Okay. But the thing to remember is you're dealing with just one part of the style, the D variation. If you want to change something else, so if I go to variation C, look, I've got to bring that one up there. If I go back to D, it remembers all my changes. I can even import and export the style as my own custom version. And over here, we've got some even more in-depth controls, such as editing the parts. But as I say, we'll go through this more in a more in-depth video. But I can press save. And I can save it in a place. So I can press save, and that will then store that as a user accompaniment. And again, there's loads, there's quite a lot in here already, but with a bit of luck, I should be able to find that somewhere in there, wherever it's gone. But yeah, there's lots in there that you can do, and you can even rename the style if you want. There's a lot of extra accompaniments in this. In this particular Wersi, actually. It's quite possible someone maybe had the Yamaha activation added to it. So I think there's loads and loads of Yamaha accompaniments, because you can actually buy a thing called a Yamaha, even a Roland style activation. And what that does is it allows you to import from Yamaha, Taurus 3 up to Genos. There it is, at Latin Impanema. So now, when I play with the other variations, variation B, it should actually still be the same accompaniment. Okay, so. Okay, yeah. Thing. Okay. D. There you go, that's our accordion, look. So you have to bear in mind that the parts, if there's a break and it uses the flute will still be active in the break, because that's where it's a bit like a piece of music that is made up of modular little songs that all play and are controlled by the chords we're playing left hand. But as you can see, we could spend all day nattering about that, but it's one that if we get the screen all plugged in, we can do some really good videos on that on our Patreon panel. And obviously the same with the MIDI sequencer, but I think that one might be a little bit more for Trevor. So anyway, thank you, Philip, for those wonderful questions. Barry Gregory, yes, but poor Barry's in bed at the moment, not too good. I'm sure we send Barry our best wishes, Barry Gregory. And yes, looking forward to the delivery tomorrow. We're hopefully it'll be on its way to you soon, Mary, your new toy. Chris Nugent up in sunny Cumbria. Thank you, Chris. Welcome. As Lawrence Easdale is watching, Roger Marshall, not said hello for months. Yeah, it's been a while, hasn't it, Roger? Yeah, welcome to you, sir. Wayne says, hit the like button. Yes, please do hit subscribe. Hit the like button. Share the video around. Wayne Lux says that. He just said that. Colin... Colin NR from Cornwall. Hello, Colin. And Willie Vercanier, I think that's pronounced. Very nice. Wersi is very good. So thank you very much, Willie, from wherever you're watching. So yes, lots of fun. Yes, Graham said it can be fun MIDI and style editing. Yeah, it's good. It's good fun style editing, because you can tweak what's already in the organ relatively simply on the surface. But yes, you can go a lot more in depth. We're just in the process of doing all the packs, our welcome packs for our show, which is in about 6 or 7 weeks' time at Peterborough. Music Extravaganza. Philip says, thank you, Tom. No worries, Philip. We'll expand more on that as we go. We are pretty much now, basically, we've been fully booked for months. One or two folks have returned a couple of rooms, but obviously had a waiting list, so those have gone. So for the last sort of 6 to 8 weeks, we've been fully booked. We've got one or two folks coming as day visitors. And yes, the programme is done. We're just getting the booklets printed. So we're looking forward to welcoming Claire and Brett and Claudia to the show. And obviously Cornelius, Tam, Lucy, myself, Trevor will be there. We've got a guy called Martin who comes to do some one-to-ones with people. And we've also got Ulrich from Wersi who comes, who represents Wersi Germany. Ulrich, many of you know Ulrich, the genius, one of the geniuses behind this amazing Wersi organ. And as well as Ulrich living in a room, we lock him in a room all weekend, so he's not allowed out. And you'll be able to speak to him about Wersi organs, chat to him about design ideas. He's always looks forward to hearing new ideas for future updates for the Sonic. But he's also going to be hosting a small informal workshop called High Tech Wersi. And I know several folks have got questions about VSTs and the more high tech side of the Wersi organ. So I believe that's on the Saturday afternoon, I think it is. He's coming to do that, which is going to be really, really nice. So yeah, that's going to be lots of good fun to and Ulrich's a really nice guy, and he loves showing off things on the organ. So so we're getting everything planned now for that, which is scary. I say not that long away. You sort of think about October, but we're now in September. So yeah, let's play another piece of music. Well, hang on, I just need to do my camera work very quickly. Let's just do that. There we go. Marvellous. Look at that. And as I'm actually on a drawbar setting, let's go for a little swingy number. That sounds good. We'll go with that, I think. And here's a swing style, I think it is. Thank you. I just felt a cold breeze, and it's Trevor. Hey. Hello, Trevor.
Oh.
How are you?
We're good. Right, we're get this turned up.
There we are. Yeah.
Hello, testing one.
Yes.
Here.
Well, I think so.
Just about. It's a funny microphone, that one.
It's a very funny microphone.
Yeah.
You're not overly loud.
Oh, well.
Yeah.
Hold that up a bit.
Yes, I shall increase you.
Give me a bit with a tweak.
Yes.
How are you all doing?
We're all right.
Yeah.
What have
I missed?
not a lot. Philip Russell's been very...
Not a lot. No. Philip Russell
was very abusive after I said, no, we can't answer any questions about the thing.
Well, that's because I wasn't here.
Was he asking
a technical question?
He was. Oh, something dear. About, I don't know, MIDI. He's a nice guy.
Did you give the Patreon response and just fob him off?
Basically, we'll do it on
Patreon.
Be ready by Christmas, yeah. We went through actually quite a little bit about it. Actually, we edited a Latin song and saved it.
Well done.
And then couldn't find it.
Yes,
because there was 20 pages of Yamaha conversion. So,
that one's got all the Yamaha stuff in it.
It has, yes. Very exciting. There we are. But no, it's been good fun. We just played a little drawbar number and we've been flying.
Excellent.
Absolutely.
So, Joan's there. Hello,
yes,
Joan.
Hello, Joan. I was about to say hello to Joan.
Come to see you soon. and Steve Swan.
Yes.
Updates on the future. Well, nothing as yet. But I think Ulrich is working very, very hard.
Yes.
And it'll be over soon anyway, in October.
In October.
So he'll probably bring it over with him then.
He normally sometimes brings a sneak peek, yes.
Mm. Paul Daniel. Yep, Paul was here. Can the overall tone be changed? This with the Lowry, did you do that?
No, I haven't answered that one yet.
Philip Russell, thank you, Tom. Graham Williams,
yes.
It'll be fun, million style editing.
It will be fun, yes.
But I've got Billy says, Wersi is good. Yeah, absolutely.
Absolutely. Yeah. And someone from somewhere.
Colin from Cornwall, and some Chinese, Japanese. I can't tell the difference,
no.
so
hello.
Sorry.
Hello.
But anyway, hello. Thank you for joining us. lots of people on there.
Lots of people.
They've all missed you because we unfortunately couldn't do a show last week.
Mm.
The week before, I think we did a pre-recorded Patreon one. So
yes.
It's nice to be back being live.
Absolutely.
So excellent.
Yes.
The
tone.
Oh yeah, that's a good question.
That's a very good question.
Very
yes.
good Wersi
I've
question.
Been even doing
Shall
my
I,
I've been doing my
do
own camera work.
I was going to say, should I do a bit
I've
of zooming
been,
for
I've
you?
I've been there. Yes. Now, of course, with this one, we hit a little bit of the tone change. Obviously, when you're hearing the Wersi on its own speakers, it's a lot more apparent. But yes, but to answer Paul's question, you can tone a Wersi in any way almost you can think of. But we do have a wonderful built-in system in the settings menu on the first page, and we've got something called the output mixer. And what that does is it basically takes the sound of the organ and outputs it to either the internal speakers. Maybe you've got some external speakers, such as a pair of Vocalis from Wersi, or a big pair of TS-9000 tower speakers, or maybe a pair of headphones. And of course, depending on where the organ lives in your home, it will sound different to if you hear maybe a friend who's got one in their home, if you sound a little different if you hear it in our showroom or at the show, because you're hearing the sound in a different environment. Of course, there's different materials and fixtures and fittings. And many times in the past, when I showed organs, you know, going back sort of 20 odd years or so, I'm sure Trevor will sort of echo this, that when someone said, oh, the organ's a bit bassy or whatever, can I change that? The answer was really, well, no. It's kind of, that's how it was. But as technology improved, we now have an equalizer. And this allows us to actually get hold of the various, think of it like a spectrum of, like a color spectrum, but a sound spectrum. And on the left side of the spectrum, actually I'm thinking of going dum 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 dum. Captain Scarlet.
What's
yes.
that got to do with equalizer?
Well, no, he worked for Spectrum, and I'm talking about Spectrum. Yes. Yeah, Spectrum.
Did he?
Yeah.
No.
Yes.
Did he?
That was the thing.
A better joke would be like, you know, some bloke's going to turn up in his Jaguar XJ6.
Yes. Anyway, moving on.
You've got to be old to get that reference.
I was going
to
say, yes.
Anybody gets the old equalizer reference. Edward Woodward.
Edward Woodward, that's going back, isn't it?
Yeah.
Crikey, yes.
Yeah. All the modern ones now is Denzel Washington, but it used to be Edward Woodward.
Yeah.
And the Equalizer.
Yes, that's going back a long way, yes. Edward Woodward, wasn't he the Wicker Man?
Could have been, yeah. He was the
policeman, wasn't he?
Yes.
Absolutely. Anyway, what was I talking about? Captain Scarlet. Sorry, Spectrum, yes. That's right, yes. Yes, yeah. Yes, no, the organisation he worked for was called Spectrum.
Was it?
Yeah, because there was Colonel White and Captain Blair. Anyway, so just as we have a colour spectrum, we have a sound spectrum. So on the left, we've got the bass. So that's the boomy bottom end of the sound spectrum. And then we've then got mid 1, 2, and 3. Now without getting sort of too technically into the sound thing, and Trevor maybe can do a video on this.
To other children's programmes.
Absolutely, and other children's programmes, yeah. It's basically kind of like the middle of the sandwich. It's the middle sound. It's not necessarily bassy or high, it's just the middle, and it allows you to make the sound fuller or less fuller, and then the treble is for the brightness end. So basically we have the output, which will be output 1, output 2, and the headphones. Now, why have we got 3 there? Well, of course, some people have a Wersi like the OX500, which has internal speakers. So all the Wersis have internal speakers except for 2 models where there's an option, that's the 600 and the 700. So if we see on those, and the 900, I was coming to that, yeah, I was working my way up, dear boy. 6, 7 and 900, and the 6 and the 7 are either just those model numbers or they have LS on the end. So the 500 is LS, the 600 and the 700 can be LS. Sometimes people don't want internal speakers for, if they want to move the organ around, and they have external speakers. The 800 has built-in speakers, the 900 doesn't, so you have to have speakers with that, and the Pergamon has built-in speakers. Even if the organ has built-in speakers, you can add extra speakers on if you want to spread the sound or annoy the neighbours. So the first output one of the outputs goes to the internal speakers. So at the bottom of there, we've got the volumes, and we've also got the EQ. And when I press that, it lights up green, and it shows me my equaliser setting over here. So let's pop on something a bit more obvious than that. Let's go for a brassy sort of tune. And so if I bring the bass down, you can hear there that it's gone, depending on what you're listening to this on, but it hasn't got any bottom end to it. If I bring it back up, look, you can then hear there's a lot more oomph. So you can obviously push the bass end quite high, or you can reduce it down. So if you think that maybe there's too much bass, you can just reduce it whilst you're playing to get that set. The middle range gives the sound more fullness or less fullness, so you can adjust those. And of course the treble, if you don't want it too bright, makes it a lot more mellow, and obviously you can push it up there and so on. So you can tone the actual speakers of the organ exactly how you want them, and then save that as your own custom sound setup, which can then be set as standard. So in other words, when you switch the organ on, it comes on all the time. We've also got a second output, which would probably be used for external speakers. And so, of course, because those speakers will be different, so if you had a pair of Vocalises, those would be different to the internal speakers. So again, you've got the same 5-band, 5-level equalisation. You can set those exactly as you want. And also, most importantly, is when you plug headphones in and the speakers cut off, obviously you want to play for silent playing, you can then set a tone setting just for your headphones. You can set them all in one go and then save that as your own custom mixer file, your own sound
file.
Your own
template, yeah.
Your own template. Mm. And so, short answer, yes.
Yeah, and you can do several of them. So you can have a different template for playing classical music, different one for jazz.
Jazz, yep.
Different one, as Thomas says, one to annoy your neighbours, a different one when you're all about the bass. No
absolutely,
trouble.
Yeah. Well, because particularly if you're playing a lot of cathedral organ and theatre organ, those instruments are inherently very big and bassy. Whereas if you were going for something more in a lighter orchestral kind of setting, you might not want so much bass. So as Trevor said, you can do many of them and all very clever. So yes, it can be done.
So it's a very long way of saying yes.
Basically.
We always like answering questions in a long way.
Yes.
But that's the nice thing about the Wersis is that they have that flexibility. Mm. And you can say, as Tom said, you can do several of your own mixer settings and store them in the organ. So you can have a different one for different bits of music.
Yeah.
You can even use the EQ for EQing the speakers differently on the organ. So the bass speakers at the bottom of the organ are EQed differently to the ones at the top.
The monitors, yeah.
It makes a lot of difference. You've got a big scope in there.
Yes, definitely. Absolutely. And it's nice and easy to do as well. You don't go into the string and go, oh my goodness, what have I done? It's nicely designed.
And so whereas that is talking about the entire tone of the organ, you do also have the ability to adjust the brightness of the individual voices.
Sounds.
When you go into sounds, you can adjust on the screen there. If you do the zoom
absolutely,
in on there.
Yeah. There we go.
The brightness of the actual sound. So you actually have a bass and treble control for individual voices, as well as the one that controls the whole organ. So when you're blending instruments together,
absolutely,
and you want something to come
definitely,
out more,
yeah.
or you know, think, oh, that trumpet's nice, but it's a bit too sharp, you can mellow it down by taking the treble down.
Absolutely.
That way.
And then save that as your own custom voice.
Yeah, you can save it as custom voice, or it's remembered as part of the total preset. Mm. You've got the flexibility of doing it either way.
Oh, so
I've got my shoulder in there.
Yes, it's shoulder cam, yes. But I was also saying to Philip in the gang that Ulrich on one of the days is going to host an informal workshop called High Tech Wersi.
I know, yes, I'm going to sit on that one.
Yeah. Maybe we should call it Supersonic or something.
Supersonic, okay.
Oh, no, isn't that the band with what's his name? No, we can't do that. Yeah.
Really on very strange tangents today.
Keep going.
Supersonic. You're talking about Oasis?
Maybe, I can't remember. Was that
Champagne Supernova?
Yeah, maybe. Yeah. Going back.
Actually, one of their albums was called Supersonic.
Was it? Okay.
Anyway.
Yes.
No, I think just a meeting with Ulrich.
Absolutely, absolutely.
Tech tips with Ulrich.
Yeah,
because actually, I think, one of the things I don't know much about, because I don't have any experience with them, is this whole idea of VSTs and things, and plugins and stuff. And so we do get asked about that from some Wersi owners. So it's going to be very interesting to learn about how all that works with Ulrich as
absolutely.
Well.
Absolutely. Yeah, very
fascinating.
Exciting.
And say maybe he might have a 2.95 with him or version 3 or whatever it's
you
going to be.
Never
called,
you never know. You never know.
Very exciting. So Alf has joined us. Hi, Alf.
Hello, Alf.
And Catherine. Catherine Coxon. She's enjoying playing her organ. She's got a very nice organ there now.
Yes.
Steve Homer has joined us. Hi, Steve. I bet he's playing his clarinet over.
Yes.
Patrick, hi. I've been trying to locate one of your broadcasts featuring the ET theme, but failed to find a tag in your Patreon app to locate it. It may be one of Lucy's. Can you help?
I think
Lucy did try that.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure if she actually did it in the end. Because if anybody knows the ET theme, it starts off really nice.
Did ET go home?
Da, 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 and then it goes into a really weird bit. I mean, a lot of people feel that it's actually one of John Williams' best scores.
Oh, it is quite something.
The part of the music when ET's leaving is like a masterclass in scoring emotion and drama and so forth.
Yeah,
incredible theme.
Well, especially at the end where it was the piano flying thing, da-da, where they've got all the arpeggios.
Just an absolutely stunning score.
Yeah, beautiful.
I've got an album of the best of John Williams, and it's on there, and it is it's just amazing to listen to.
He was 90 earlier this year, wasn't he?
Indeed, still working.
Still working.
Scored the rather lukewarm received Indiana Jones movie this
year.
He still scored that. Yeah.
Haven't seen that, no.
All accounts, we haven't missed much.
Okay.
So I'm not sure if Lucy actually did that one. Let me have a look.
Okay.
I shall call up the computer and have a look.
Shall I play another song while we're waiting?
Yeah.
Okay.
Do you know, actually, that's also a good moment to introduce the fact that we have started, there's a new feature on Patreon where we've created a collections. Mm-hmm. So when you are searching for things, you can look for an entire playlist now, all in one go. So let me have a look. It might speed things up for me.
Yes.
Are you going to play some music on it?
I am. I'm just going to decide what to play.
Stephen's actually told us that Edward Woodward played the spy in the British TV series Callan, the Equalizer in the American TV series, amongst many other roles.
Okay.
He was married to Michel Dautriche.
Well,
some others do have them.
That's you, isn't
sorry.
It?
Sorry. Turn that one down.
Right, well, I'll play a tune.
Okay. I'll turn myself down.
Yeah. Style there. Yeah. Good fun.
I'm having a look through. I don't think Lucy actually ever did E.T.
Okay.
I think it's one of those songs where she looked at it and thought about it, and then the middle bit was a bit weird.
Right.
It's not one that we actually did as a video. I can't see it there anywhere. So
no.
Sorry, Patrick.
Maybe one to do at some point.
Maybe one for Tom to do, maybe, yeah.
Yeah, we could ask him, couldn't we?
I better go and answer that phone. I'm sorry, Tom.
That's all right.
I shall
carry on. Might see you at the end. Stephen John Presnell, Edward Wood. Oh, you've done another one. Yes, some others who haven't. Yeah, absolutely. It's, yeah, it's not all those names that, you know, sort of the... They were sort of staples of the old days. And yes, either... gone on to the big theatre in the sky, or of course retired. Actually, there's a really cool a compliment up here. We've got the pop section where we've got 16 beats, 8 beats, loads of stuff. Thank you. That's lovely. 16 beat number one in the pop section with, of course, Arthur's theme there with Dudley Moore in the lead role. So, yeah, so beautiful, beautiful sounds. And, of course, that was using the sounds to styles, which are these four buttons down here. And we often have these on the panel as well. And these are just four setups to get us started with sounds that are appropriate for that particular style. I've also got switched on my OTS thing at the bottom, which is putting in my split point for me. So when I actually play with a particular US ballad, let's say. I've actually got on the lower keyboard a split sound. So, for example, if I just zoom out again, let's just do my solo camera work a moment. There we are, bring that out like that. There we are. So I can now do this, you see. Get that nice voice on the lower keyboard and four different tones there from STS. Oh, hello.
Hello, I'm back again.
You're back again. Yes, you have returned.
Were you using the STS?
I was. I was, yes.
That's good.
Yes,
all there.
Yes, all there. Yes. I didn't realise it was switched on by the previous owner. So I was like, why does my thing keep running out? So, yes,
both. Does that mean that that's a beautiful pre owned OAX500?
I believe it. I think it is. And it's just, I said that, but it's just arrived and needs a new home.
Absolutely.
Straight, it's like in the next 10 minutes. but yeah, lovely, because this is the pearlescent white, which is a lovely finish. Yeah, beautiful, nice. Beautiful.
I was going to do a little plug, Patreon plug, actually, and just show everybody the new collection.
Absolutely.
That's been added.
Shall I press the button?
So you can press the button, Tom. So for anybody who's not familiar, we have a Patreon channel. We may have mentioned it just a few times on these live streams.
Once or twice.
For anybody that enjoys our videos and or just enjoys the hobby of playing the organ at home. On the Patreon website, they have added this new feature. If we go to our main page, dropping into my Norfolk speak.
That's boy, that's tidy, isn't it?
And normally when you go onto our Patreon site, you can see all the videos we've done recently. So there's one that Tom put up there 2 hours ago about how to play with the ending.
It's changed, doesn't it?
And there's one
work,
that I did a bit earlier yesterday, where I was being shallow.
Was this an omission of...
Yeah, yes. intellectually so.
Yes.
I'll tell you what was fun about that. It was taking this piece of music, Shallow, this pop song, and analysing how it works and
great.
How it's all put together.
Nice.
That was fun. And we're going to do some presets for it and so forth. But what's interesting is they've added this new feature called collections. And it doesn't mean we're going to send them the collection agents.
Yes.
it means that we've now been able to group all the videos we've done into playlists or collections, as they call it. And what's been interesting is actually discovering how many videos we actually have made on these different subjects. So, for example, if you want to learn about music theory, we have done 85 videos on music theory. If you like to learn about or listen to older organs, we've done 43 videos on what we call Mature Monday on our vintage instruments. Lucy has done 104 lessons.
That's amazing.
And our wonderful video instruction manuals that we've been compiling for the Lowry organs and for the Wersi organs there. The Lowry Back to Basics series has now got 40 videos, and the Wersi Wunders has got 44
videos. That's great. And you can still search by the tags at the bottom.
So you can still search properly as you would do normally. So these are all the videos which are being tagged and so forth. But the whole joy of the collections is that if you are a Wersi owner and you're new to Patreon, you can come straight on here, and you want to learn about your Wersi organ, you can click on Wersi Wunders, and you can see all of the Wersi videos that we've produced on that series. I mean, there's lots of other Wersi videos doing concerts and things.
Yeah.
But all the ones where we're going through explaining how to work the organ there, the one there on the panel buttons, and there on the sound panel
presets,
buttons, and there's Tom there. Oh, I don't know what you're doing there in that face there.
Yeah,
Wallace and Gromit kind of
YouTube.
Look.
YouTube. Yeah. Strings, Gromit. We've got some strings.
Great. Anybody that's thinking about signing up to Patreon, it's now even easier to find all the content and find the stuff they're looking for. And as I say, it's amazing actually how much video content is on there.
Yes.
You can sit and watch this for hours and hours and hours and hours and hours. And you can download presets from there and pre-sheet music as well, and all kinds of
things. Goes on and on and on.
It's the site that just keeps on giving.
Yes.
Keith Rose has joined us.
Hey, Keith.
It's a bit late. He fell asleep.
That's fair enough.
Not before you started, Tom.
No, I was going to say, yeah. No, Tom's...
It has gone quiet on the chat, but it's nice. We've had a fantastic audience.
Lovely, yes, really something.
I apologise that I've had to pop in and
out. Not at all, absolutely.
A little bit short-staffed at the moment.
We are, yes. Everyone's been sending best wishes to Con, and and we've been passing those on.
He's going to be back soon.
Absolutely.
Absolutely. So I haven't got any more to add apart from, that's it, I think.
I think so, yeah absolutely.
So if last chance for any questions.
Yeah. If not, I shall
have
a
closing number.
A final number. Set. Maybe a bit of country.
Which country are you choosing?
I don't know.
Hey. That's our oldest joke, isn't it?
It's still there. dearie me. Well, someone has to. That sounds nice. Oh, yeah, I like that.
Yeah.
Bit of that country pop.
So, Tom, have you done a plug for the concert that you were telling me about?
Oh, no.
Hello,
no,
oh,
I haven't. No. I know. Sorry, about most important thing of all. we will put this on the Patreon page. That's that word again. Yeah. And this Sunday, I'll be down in Kent, somewhere near Ashford. I can't quite remember where it is off the top of my head, playing a concert. Quite a unique venue, actually. A gentleman who spent a lot of time, a lot of money building with friends and people a community centre. Which has grown and grown and grown and grown and has raised lots of money for various charities. But they host various music events there. And the actual centre actually has organs inside it. And they actually, the guy who has it purchased a very nice Lowry organ from us, and it's there for any concert artists who want to play. And they've got a Roland organ, and they've got an Allen Theatre organ as well. So I'm going to be going down there and playing some music on the Lowry and doing a sonnet film show and a concert. That's on this Sunday afternoon. So yeah, I shall put the details
on Patreon, and sure, if you go to Tom's website.
Yes.
TomHorton.co.uk.
Absolutely.
There'll be all the details on there.
Very exciting.
Yes.
So that's what I'm doing this weekend.
Absolutely. And then the week after, we're going to be at the Pakefield Organ Festival.
On the Tuesday,
big night on the Tuesday. Is the Allen's night, as it were.
Yes, celebrating 75 years.
Tom will be playing on the Ringway, I'll be playing on the Lowry, and Claudia will be playing on the
Wersi. Yes.
So we will be covering all three makes that we
look after, yes, absolutely.
So that's going to be a fun night.
That's going to be big, isn't it?
Yeah. I'm sandwiched in the middle.
You are.
Between you and Claudia.
Absolutely.
It's quite a strange place, actually, because normally I'm the warm-up guy, so I'm not going to handle that.
Oh, you'll make it. You'll make it. You'll be all right. Here we go with some country. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Uh-huh.